Welcome to the Community Kids Online. My name is Charlotte, and today is our final lesson in our series, Brave. Before we get to that, it's time for our Community Kids values. Remember, I'll say the value, and you shout out the reason why. Here we go. Number one, love God. Why? Number two is love people. Why? And number three is do your best. Why? And the last one, number four, have fun. Why? Great job, everyone. We are going to head over to Cool Carl. He seems to be in a super good mood today, and he's got something important to say to Cassie. So let's check it out.
Hi there, little chicken nuggets. It's me, Carl. Welcome to Grow TV.
Welcome to Grow TV. Introducing your host, Carl.
And your co-host, Cassie. Where we learn, where we grow, and we talk about Jesus. Once again, welcome to Grow TV.
Hi there, everybody. So glad you can come hang out with your old buddy Carl today. And I'm not gonna lie, I'm in a good mood today. And nothing is gonna ruin it. I'm on cloud nine. On top of the world. I couldn't be happier. Too blessed to be stressed. Know what I'm saying?
Hey, Carl.
Hey, Cassie. How are you on this glorious day?
I don't know.
What? How do you not know?
I just don't know.
Well, what's got you down?
I just feel tired.
Well, that's not good. We gotta cheer you up.
I just don't know if that's possible.
Well, sure it is. My motto in life is, you can always cheer someone up if you try hard enough.
Is that really your motto?
Nope, but it is now.
All right, so what do you want to do?
How about this? We play a game called Toe or Finger.
What? How do you play that?
Easy. You just close your eyes and I put either a toe or finger under your nose and you have to guess which one it is.
That sounds awful.
Okay, how about we play, does that dog bite? We go up to random dogs and pet them and see if they're gonna bite us or not.
That's a terrible idea. We could get hurt.
That's true, probably shouldn't do that. So what games are we gonna play?
How about some true or false?
True or false? Like I ask a question and you guess whether it's true or false?
Sure.
Awesome, true or false? First one, some cats are allergic to humans.
False.
True! Gotcha! True or false? A group of dolphins is called a pod.
True.
False! Wait, no, you're right. It's true.
Told ya.
Yeah. Alrighty, Miss Smarty Pants. See if you can get this one. True or false? Fish live in water.
Really? That's the question?
What? Too difficult? I told you I was a master of true and false.
True. Obviously, fish live in water.
Wait. How'd you know that?
Everyone knows that. Are you serious?
All right, last one. True or false? God has a plan for everyone.
I don't know.
You don't know?
I'm gonna go with false? Maybe true? I don't know.
What are you talking about? Of course God has a plan for everyone. What are you even saying?
I don't know. I guess God does have a plan for everyone, but sometimes I feel like he doesn't have one for me.
What do you mean?
Well, like today I'm tired. I don't feel like doing anything. And I don't feel like God has a plan for me today.
Well, just because we're tired doesn't mean anything.
What about the mistakes I've made? I've messed up a lot of my life, and I just don't see how God can have a plan for somebody who messes up so much.
Easy there, Down Cassie. Miss, I didn't get enough sleep last night. God has a plan for you. The Bible is full of stories of people that have messed up, but still did amazing things.
Like who?
Look at Moses. He did a lot of things that were wrong, but God still used him to save countless lives. And what about Peter? He doubted Jesus, denied Jesus, and was pretty selfish at times. Yet, he became one of the greatest leaders in the Bible.
I guess that's true.
And don't forget about who we learned about last week.
You mean Esther?
Of course. I mean, look at her whole story. As a Jewish woman, she was never supposed to become a queen, but she did. And she was never supposed to talk to the king without being summoned, but she did. And because of her faithfulness, God used her to save her family and her friends. Without her, so many people would have died. And you don't think God didn't have a plan for her?
I guess you're right, but what about me?
That's the cool thing, Cassie. God loves us all the same. There's nothing that you can do to make God love you any more or any less.
Really?
Really, really.
That makes me feel good.
Me too. And we can't forget how much God loves us and how important God's plan is for us. And Cassie, you're a once in a whole universe type of person. And there's something about you that is the direct reflection of God's love.
Thanks, Carl. I'm not sure why I even doubted God. I know now that God has a purpose for my life and a plan for my life.
Oh, Cassie.
What? What's wrong?
I'm just so proud of you.
What? Why?
Not only do you know that God has a plan for your life, but you just sent her big idea.
I did?
Yeah. You did! That's our big idea!
Well, apparently, today's big idea is God has a plan for my life.
Yep, we must never forget that. So on the count of three, let's all say it together. One,
two,
three. God has a plan for my life!
All right!
Woo, woo, woo! So Cassie, how do you feel now?
Still tired, but happy. Happy that God cares about me.
Isn't that the truth? Speaking of truth, true or false? I need a snack right now.
True?
Yeah! That's true. See you, everyone.
Thank you for watching, and tune in next week for a new episode of Bro TV.
Last week, we left off with Queen Esther in a precarious situation. She had bravely gone before the king, and he accepted her request and offered to give her anything she asked for, including to half the kingdom. She invited the king and his top official, Haman, to dinner. Remember Haman? He's the guy who wants to kill all of Esther's people, the Jews. But no one knows that Esther is Jewish. Her uncle, Mordecai, is hated by Haman because he won't bow down before Haman. And now, Haman is getting ready to go before the king in the morning and get permission to have Mordecai executed before the banquet that evening. Well, here's what happened. It was the night before the feast Esther had arranged for the king and Haman. Haman had ordered a gallows be built to hang Mordecai. The king, however, could not sleep, so he asked a servant to read to him about the events of his reign. When the details of the plot that Mordecai had uncovered were read, he called for his servants. "Search the royal records and see if I ever thanked Mordecai." The servants reported that Mordecai had not been thanked. The next morning, Haman had hurried to see the king. This was his chance to ask that Mordecai be hanged on his gallows. Before he could make his request, the king asked him a question. "How should I honor a man I want to reward?" the king asked. Thinking that the king wanted to honor him, Haman replied, "Dress him in a royal robe, put him on the king's horse, led by one of the most noble princes, and lead him through the city shouting, 'The king honors this man.'" "Good idea," replied the king. "Go and do all of that for Mordecai." Haman silently fumed. He had to lead Mordecai, dressed in royal robes, on horseback, through the city shouting, "This is how the king honors this man." After that, Haman went home feeling humiliated and angry, but he still had the feast with the king and queen to look forward to. After eating some fine food at the feast, the king turned to Esther and asked if there was anything he could give her. "I have one request," said Esther. "I and my people are about to be destroyed by someone in your kingdom. We need protection." "Who would dare to kill you?" thundered the king. Esther pointed at Haman. Haman sank down in his chair. "Guards!" shouted the king. Haman collapsed at Esther's feet and clutched at her. When the king saw Haman clutching at Esther's dress, he thought Haman was trying to attack her. "Seize that man!" he shouted. A guard grabbed Haman and dragged him away. One of the servants approached the king. "Your Majesty," he said, "Haman built a gallows and wanted to hang your friend Mordecai on it." The king immediately ordered that Haman be hanged on the gallows instead. Soon after that, Queen Esther asked the king if he could cancel the command for all the Jews to be destroyed. The king could not. It was a rule that the law of the Medes and Persians could not be changed.
But, said the king, I could make a new command. The Jews can defend themselves from anyone who attacks them. So on the day when the Jews were supposed to be killed, anyone who tried met a well-armed team of Jews ready to fight back. So all the Jews were saved. Haman was dead, and Mordecai was promoted to a high rank. God had answered their prayers in a most dramatic way. The story of Esther shows us how God uses people from all nations to carry out his plans and purposes. He answers prayer and rescues those who call out to him for help. God may have put you in a position where you can serve him.
So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. Isaiah 41:10.
All right, kids, Pastor Jason is here, and I am going to challenge him to a tower building contest. So here's how it's going to work. We get 5 minutes to construct the tallest tower we can using popsicle sticks and marshmallows, okay? But you only get 5 minutes, and whoever's tower is the tallest is the winner.
Okay.
All righty? You ready?
Let's do this. Yeah,
okay.
I'm ready.
Here we go. Ready, set, go. Making a plan or working a plan? Or do you like to be the plan maker or the plan doer? The good news is God is good at both, and he has a good plan for your life. Even when you mess up, God can work all of that into his plan for you. All you have to do is trust him.
Walking around me,
God does have a plan for your life in the same way He had a plan for Esther. He created each of us for a purpose. The biggest part of that purpose is to be in relationship with Jesus. And just like Queen Esther saved her people, God sent Jesus to save all of us. Jesus came to earth for the purpose of being your Savior, King, and friend. You see, Jesus is our Savior. He forgives us. He sacrificed for us by dying on the cross and then showed us He has the power to forgive our sins by raising from the dead 3 days later. And nothing we do wrong can ever turn away His love for us. Jesus is our King. He protects us. He leads us. He provides for us. He frees us from sin that would hold us down and keep us from being who we were created to be. And Jesus is our friend. He never leaves us. He listens to us. He cares deeply for us. And if you want to start a relationship with Jesus, just follow Jesus as your Savior, King, and friend. Love Him and others the way He loves you. And as you live and love like Jesus, tell others about it. If you want to make the choice to follow Jesus and to live your whole life depending on His power to help you say no to sin, talk to your parents or reach out to us. We would love to help you in your journey with Jesus. And if you know someone who needs to hear this message, share it with them. But until next time, be a light and shine bright.